can't believe Firewalk is playing a show at the old mill. Fuck yes! Mom would kill me if she knew I was out here. Holy shit. This place is awesome. If I'm gonna get inside, I'll have to get through that door.
Help you, miss?
You gotta let me in. Check it. I'm totally legit.
It's not a bad fake, kid. But you're in over your head here. Do yourself a favor and scram.
Can't let him push me around. Should I go back and stand up to... Nothing says badass like a nice floral print. Guess fire safety isn't exactly high on the agenda here. Now what to draw? Hey kids! Free candy. Seriously, though, who drives an RV to a Firewalk show?
Meaning you. Yeah, your problem.
God, again? What do you want, kid?
I have to convince this doorstop that I'm not giving up until he lets me inside. Don't you remember what it's like to be a teenager? I just want to see the band.
I thought we went over this. Isn't it past your bedtime?
Aww, isn't it past yours?
Real cute. But I still don't know you.
Look at my face. Do I look cute? Or do I look like I'm going to kick your ass?
Okay, kid. I get it. You're tough.
Maybe I am a kid. Because this place looks like a damn playground to me.
Girl like you? I can't protect you in there.
A girl like you, with pretty, pretty flowers on her bicycle, shouldn't lecture me on what I can do.
That is a traditional Samoan... Look, my boss decides who gets in, all right?
Is your boss your mom? Follow up. Do you live in your boss's basement?
You're not accepting no for an answer, are you?
Nope.
And you really think you can take me?
Yep.
What if I had a knife?
No problem.
A gun?
Don't care.
What if I had...
You could have a flamethrower, an army of robot ninjas, and a motherfucking dragon on a leash in there, and I'd still kick your ass.
I give up. You're all right, kid. Go on in.
This is intense! Shit!
Hey, Delia! Come!
Cute dog. Just follow the lights and the sound. Can't wait to get in there and thrash. Half those stairs are rotted through. Looks dicey. Sober up, girl. You're missing the show.
Yeah, I mean...
Hey, are you selling
20
any...
20 bucks.
What?
20 bucks for a t-shirt.
That's really expensive. Dip.
No. Look, we have to set this up exactly as I explained it to you.
Looks like that parking brake is the only thing keeping that car from rolling down the ramp.
No. Look, we have to set this up Hey, I told you 20 bucks. You looking to get beat?
That guy's a dick. If I want a shirt, I'm going to need to get creative. Sorry, dude. Maybe you shouldn't overcharge.
Shit! No! Come on!
Thanks for playing, dick. Oh, yeah! Sweet, sweet victory. That's like 200 bucks. Holy shit! I'm rich! Nothing sadder than a neglected bong. Sweet knife. Just like the one my mom refused to get me for my birthday. Here we go. Fuck.
Hey, you okay?
I'm fine.
Relax. You bumped into me, remember?
Yep. My bad, dude.
You don't know who I am, do you?
Nope. Don't care, either.
Hey, let me know how that works out for you,
bitch.
All right. Mosh pit is a no-go. Fine. Maybe I can get a better view of the action from up above.
Hey.
Chloe?
I know your name, you idiot. You bought pot for me every month for a year. Look at that getup. Studs. You're trying too hard. What are you even doing here?
I'm trying to see this damn band. But this place is crazy packed. Hard to get to the stage.
How'd you even hear about this little shindig?
Ha! The internet. How else?
Seriously? Fucking kids.
Where do those stairs go?
Up?
Real helpful, Frank. I mean, will I get a better view of the band up there?
How the fuck should I know? Floor above's rotted all to hell, okay? No one goes up there.
Fine. Did you see that guy I ran into? Acted like I was supposed to know who the hell he was.
Yeah. I know him. He works for Damon.
Damon who?
This is his place. He's a friend of mine.
I'll see you later.
Whatever.
Who get butthurt over a spilled beer.
I think she's calling us out, dude.
She's gonna regret every word. Every word.
Oh, this is gonna be good.
I'm gonna teach this little punk some manners.
I'm serious. You wanna see me get angry here? Because I'm getting there. And it won't be pretty. It won't.
She thinks she can take you?
Hey, dickhead.
Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell. Daily rituals are important. Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise.
Rolling! Wakey, wakey, eggs and bacon!
Last night, seeing Firewalk live. Those skeevy assholes. That girl. Was that really Rachel Amber? You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes. I really should get going.
You're listening to our
shit. Where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's. Okay. Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, scourge of Arcadia Bay. Mom's old engagement ring. Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pawn. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring? Can't believe I used to sneak in there for her makeup. I made this for Mom when I was like 10 years old. If she wore it now, I'm not... How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating? Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
Chloe, breakfast. Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah, okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room.
Oh, can you grab my cell phone too? No more dawdling. I need to talk to you.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry.
Coming, Mom.
Finally, you can put my purse on the dining table. Might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Dining table, here I come.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see what Mom wants before she strokes out. Hey, Mom. You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame, too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole. Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then?
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah, I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, "What are you gonna eat?"
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Tired, huh? That'll teach you to break curfew.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that—
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Ever again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
I think it's great David's taking an interest. He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious? This is such—
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not? Mom, I know you're dealing with a lot.
Thank you. I understand you don't need me as much anymore. But I need you.
I do still need you. You're my mom.
I'm proud of you for being so self-sufficient. But the whole world's not out to get you.
Tell that to the world.
You're impossible. But I love you.
I love you too.
Mm-hmm. Okay, David's waiting. You'll need to bring him his keys from the ashtray. Try not to kill each other.
Get it. Unless he tries to give me advice. Or looks at me funny.
Chloe.
Or looks at me at all.
Chloe.
Mom.
Have a good day.
You too. Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
You're welcome. Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk.
Wow. Sean Press. Why do I-
This is Principal Ray Wells. Let me be emphatic. I have an enormous stick inserted into my butt.
Crap. I forgot David's keys. That's probably worth at least 10 push-ups. Here they are. Let's get these to date. No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. They better get going. What a piece of crap. The car, too.
Why do you women always take forever to get ready?
We're hoping you men will leave without us.
No, Mom. I swear he beat himself to death with a tire iron. Repeatedly.
Chloe, is that a black eye?
No.
Insubordination. No wonder your mother's worried about you.
Oh, that's sweet.
When I was your age, I got into my share of scraps. But it's not responsible. You owe it to your mother to do better.
Tell me again what I owe my mother, dirtbag.
Electrode insulator's probably cracked. You know what a spark plug does?
Yes.
It ignites.
Did you not hear me? I said I know what it does.
Then go grab my socket wrench set from the garage, and we can get moving.
What is this? Quality time? Ugh. Better just get the socket. What's David doing, leaving stuff in our garage anyway? Does he think he's moving in or something? Fifty-fifty chance I smash him in the face with this. 60-40. Maybe 90-10. So?
You find the socket wrench set yet? You can do that one simple thing, can't you? A little more hustle wouldn't have killed you. See what's gunking up the works there? That's a sign of
carbon deposits. No shit.
You know, you could actually be good at this if you lost the attitude.
My attitude is what makes me special, David.
All right.
Fine. Whatever.
Hey, you're taking those tools with you, right?
Every house needs a good toolbox.
We've already got one, but thanks.
Ready to roll?
Please don't want to talk. Please don't want to talk.
I
want
to talk to you about something.
Fuck.
We don't have to like each other, but you will respect me. You've enjoyed enough of a vacation from having a father figure. So there's some things I want to be real clear about.
Mm-hmm.
Joyce, your mother, she's hurting, Chloe. Hurting for you. You've had it rough, no doubt about it. But all this staying out late, ignoring her command, drinking, drug use, it's making everything harder for her. You need to shape up, get your act together, and put someone else first for a damn change. Am I making myself clear?
Is it crazy if part of what David's saying makes sense to me?
Got it. Thanks. We should really get going.
Glad we understand each other.
Country music? Dad loved this song. I just called to tell you that I miss you, my old friend. Burning the midnight oil again. What a beautiful day. I guess Mom left her purse back here. I know what a spark plug does, jerkwad.
Dad, turn it up.
Picking up my lover from the grocery store.
The hell?
Out of the car, Chloe. You're gonna be late.
Shit. Thanks.
Don't use that sarcastic tone with me, young lady. I can see you rolling your eyes.
Hello? I was actually saying
I see everything.
I'll warn everything.
Hello, Black Hell.
Hey, Chloe.
Oh, hey, Elliot.
Wait, what happened to your face? Do you need to go to the nurse or something?
What? This? You should see the other guy.
Guess it's true then. I heard you had a hell of a night. I mean, people are talking about it.
Who exactly is talking shit about me?
You know, haters on social media.
Great. I wish I could tell everyone to just get a life.
So, how about The Tempest? Blackwell Theater at its most pretentious.
Yeah, totally.
I know it's gonna be lame, but I was thinking, do you want to go together tomorrow?
I try to make it a rule not to go to school any more than I have to. But sitting in the back row and making fun of the drama kids might not suck.
Right? That's totally what I was thinking.
All right. See you in chem.
Yeah, for sure.
Gotta track down Steph to pick up my DVD. I've still got time before class. Hey, Skip. Stopped any gang wars lately?
Not today. Oof, looks like you did, though.
Huh? Ah, right. Whatever.
I did ask Justin Williams' mom to move her Mercedes out of handicapped parking.
Badass.
Yeah, you know how I roll.
I've got to get to class. Let's talk later, Skip.
Sure, Chloe.
If I had known the Celestial Avenger was bloodied, I would have totally given him my potion.
It was a skill challenge. Potion wouldn't have worked.
Skill challenge?
It's part of the tabletop game we play.
You wouldn't understand.
Give me a break, nerds. I've heard of tabletop games.
Cool.
Got my DVD?
One Blade Runner. Director's cut coming right up.
Sweet. $5, right?
Keep it. I'm just glad someone here appreciates the classics. You even asked for the director's cut, which took out the shitty voiceover and replaced it with a sweet dream sequence.
Dream life over real life. That's my motto.
Right on.
Hey, do you know if Rachel's a gamer?
Rachel Amber? You're asking me?
Didn't you two go out last night, or was it just like a friend thing?
I don't know what you heard, but Rachel and I barely know each other.
Oh, sweet.
Steph has a crush.
Chloe, you should join our game.
Yeah, I don't have 50 hours right now. Thanks, though.
We're at the end of the campaign, so it'll only take, like, 20 minutes? What else have you got to do before class?
What the hell? Game on, nerds.
Here's a character sheet. You are an elf barbarian.
Nice. I could totally see myself as an elf barbarian.
I know. I'm good. All right, let's get started. You are both famous heroes in the Kingdom of Avernon, a once peaceful land, now laid to waste by the bloodthirsty raiders of the Black Well. Alone, you have fought your way through the raider camps, seeking their warlord leader, Durgaron, the Unscarred. As you enter the final camp, bloodied and weary, you see your fellow hero approaching from the opposite direction.
I raise my staff to you in greeting. I am Elamon, wizard of the Third Circle, foremost advisor to King Tiberius, and sworn defender of Avernon.
Introduce your character.
Yeah, okay. I'm an elf barbarian named, Calamastia.
Super into it.
Not bad.
The two heroes.
Hold on. Elamon narrows his eyes at the elf in front of him and says, I am here to defeat Durgaron, the Unscarred. In the name of King Tiberius, what makes you think you are worthy to fight alongside me?
I once stabbed a guy in the chest with a sword, and it went all the way through and killed the guy behind him, too. True story.
You stand at a three-way crossing. To your left, the raiders' training ground. To your right, their prison camp. Straight ahead, an enormous, ostentatious tent that could only belong to Durgaron, the Unscarred. Which way do you go?
Straight ahead, right? We're supposed to kill the dude.
Elamon frowns. The raiders could have some good loot at the training ground, and surely it is our duty to free all those prisoners.
Your choice, newbie. Where do you wish to go?
It's tent time.
Are you sure you want to skip the training ground and the prison camp?
You heard me. Let's do the boss battle.
You enter the tent to find Durgaron, warlord of the raiders of the Black Well, sitting comfortably at his throne. He's a huge red-eyed minotaur, swathed in a fine black cloak, gripping a two-handed sword that's easily 6 feet long. His laughter bellows, wah, ha, 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 ha. Your lands and people are already mine. Your deeds here mean nothing. Your kingdom was weak. You are weak.
What an asshole.
I got this. I cast Zael's cataclysmic cone of fire.
The fire fizzles out on contact. Durgaron laughs again, holding up his right arm to show off his bracer of fire immunity.
Shit! All of my battle spells are fire-based.
Calamastia? What'll it be?
I want to punch that stupid man-cow in the dick!
Like, right in the dick?
Right in the dick.
You miss. Durgaron burst out laughing as you stumble past him.
Asshole.
He gores you in the side with a horn. 8 damage.
Ouch.
What do you do next?
What's Wrathful Rush?
It's like a shoulder slam, an angry, angry shoulder slam.
Okay, I do that.
You scream with wrathful rage, then charge. Durgaron is caught off guard, and he fails to dodge. You slam your shoulder into him, knocking him back and doing some damage.
Hell yeah.
Next.
Holy shit! Annihilation Strike. That sounds boss as fuck.
One?
That's bad, right?
Not for me. As you take your first step, you trip on a rock, collapsing onto the ground in a clangy jumble of metal. Your axe swings wildly to the side. Mikey, roll a reflex save.
Oh no, 3.
Your axe strikes Elamon's leg. Legs, plural, severing both feet at the ankles.
I am so sorry.
Durgaron moves toward the crippled Elmon.
Oh, shit!
I told you this was my best boss.
You didn't tell me my character might die.
Durgaron approaches, stomping his bloody hooves. Stomp, stomp, stomp.
This is all my fault. Sort of. What should I...
I say something really encouraging to Elmon.
Like what?
Yeah? Like what?
Shit. Why is being nice so hard?
Never, ever give up.
Word.
Elamon feels inspired. He summons the strength necessary to crawl away from Durgaron. Okay. Durgaron has now turned his attention toward you.
Bring it.
He charges, thrusting madly with his great sword.
Shit!
Oh, no.
Your attempt to dodge his thrust fails. Durgeron laughs as he impales you on his blade, lifting you high into the air.
Seriously?
I can't do anything with that stupid bracer. I'm sorry, Chloe.
Hey, I chopped your feet off. We're even.
You feel your strength draining away as Durgeron lifts you higher into the air. It hurts like hell. What do?
I bring my axe down onto his arm. The one with the fire bracer thingy.
Oh, brilliant!
You'll have to roll high to hit. You're almost dead.
20!
Fuck yes!
You bring your axe down in a wicked chop, severing his arm completely. His bracer of fire immunity clangs to the ground.
I cast Gignomi's Fire Strike of Flame!
Ooh, snap!
Lying on the ground, you conjure a flaming spear, which flies from your hands to spear Durgeron in the chest, incinerating him completely from the inside out.
Damn, Elamon!
Durgeron is defeated, but your wounds were too great. I'm afraid Calamastia is dead.
I actually feel sad right now.
Better to have died a hero than live as a coward.
That was fun.
Check out what I drew.
Mikey's got serious drawing skills.
Glad you enjoyed it, Chloe.
Yeah. I'll adventure with you anytime.
We'll see. Thanks for the game, nerds.
DVD, check. Next stop, chemistry class.
Joy.
What the hell?
What have you got here, Twitch?
Don't call me that!
True North. A jock so dumb he makes jocks look bad. Guess Nathan Prescott made the shit list.
Oh, wow. This is some really weird crap, Prescott.
It's not yours. Give it back!
I hate that you're on the team now. You're such a loser.
Guys, no need to fight. You can both be losers.
The mute speaks? Whoa! You earn a spot on the squad, Twitch. You don't have your dad try to buy off the coach.
At least my family pays tuition. How much financial aid does your deadbeat dad need again?
Wow. Dick move, Nathan.
My dad lost his job at the shipyard when your dad closed it down. And you want to talk shit to me?
Leave Nathan alone!
You know something, Prescott? I'm gonna do you a favor. You can't be a part of the team and be into this stupid crap at the same time.
You're a piece of shit. I am going to kill you.
You guys, stop! Chloe, do something! Don't just stand there watching!
The only way to stop a bully is to be aggressive. I've got to put Drew down.
Back off, idiot.
What the hell did you just say to me?
Idiot. You're not used to a word that big, are you? Don't be scared.
You're seriously defending Nathan Prescott?
How about picking on someone your own size? Which I hear is pretty small.
You're such a crazy freak. Mind your own business.
You have no idea how crazy I am. Keep pushing and find out.
You want a piece of this?
You mean your budding bromance with Nathan? You're clearly into him. Just pull his hair already.
Did you just laugh?
I did. Chloe just owned you.
Shut the fuck up, fresh meat!
You shut the fuck up!
Go Samantha.
Guess you got lucky this time, Prescott. Had two girls show up to save you. Take your pervy picture book.
Are you okay?
You think I need help? From you?
You're welcome.
Are you all right? Thanks for sticking up for him. People think just because of his family.
Everything okay here?
No problem, Skip.
Thank you.